You're going to
one more time?
Oh, okay. Then we do.
Believe all things.
and hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends, and now faith, hope, and love abide. These three, and the greatest of all of these, is love, the word of the Lord.
Lights, please.
Augustine, the theologian, writes, God loves each of us as if there were only one of us. My mom thought that God loved us unconditional because even if you do something bad or messed up, God still loves you.
God loves all, like my mother's love, and that it's very forgiving. Like if I were to ever like mess up or like stray off like my path in life, the Lord is just there like to forgive me like with like open arms.
My mother's love is like God's love because it will protect him. For example, my mother drives me to the bus stop in the morning to keep me out of the dark and to keep me safe.
One reason why God and my mom's life is because they both appeal to want to get hurt and make mistakes. Basically. Because one time when I was riding my bike, I took a short turn down the way, and my bike slid and got all over the world. Rash, and my mom healed me up and took me to the doctor to get it checked back and make sure it wouldn't get infected.
My mom's love is like God's love, and they're both determined. No matter what, they're always going to love me.
That God's love is a lot like my mom's love in a way that's so compassionate and like so sweet and full-hearted. You can feel it in your heart and it makes you warm inside. My mom's love is like God's love because she's forgiving and it's endless.
David Jeremiah writes,
Saving us is the greatest and most concrete demonstration of God's love, the definitive display of His grace throughout time and eternity.
Lights, please.
Thank you. good is the abundant life of love in Christ Jesus. We pray for the life of the church, the lives of people who are in need, and the life of all creation.
Declare your righteousness through the blossoming of creation, by the wind blowing and birds singing. Inspire us to join with him of all creation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Reveal yourself to those who feel isolated for the illness, grief, status, or the prejudice of others. Comfort and welcome them into your spirit-filled community. Today, especially we name Carol, Joe, Rudy, Shirley, Peter, Melissa, Bob, Ken, Ken, James, Kathy, Nancy, Betty, Dawn, Bill, Michelle, Sandra, John, Wayne, Jay, Phil, Vince, Danny, and Danny Goodell, Gary, Alan, Beth, Dick, Phyllis. We pray for those who now name before you, either out loud or in the silence of our hearts. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless those who serve in a motherly role for others. Send your spirit to those who mourn, who have not known their mothers, who have not longed to be a mother. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We deliver all this into your care, O God, trusting in the work of your Holy Spirit to bring all things into the risen life of Christ our Lord. Amen. May the peace of Christ be with you all. Construction company that will be coming in to bring up the bricks, take out the roots, lay a French drain in to take away the moisture that's near the side of the church. So that'll be the next step that has to be done. In the back of this bulletin here, notice that next Sunday is Pentecost Sunday. It is the custom here at St. Luke to cover the front of our altar with red geraniums. And where is our wonderful Jean? There she is. And Jean says, You want geraniums, you gotta get them in quick. Is that true, Jean?
That's true.
Okay, so keep that in mind. Keep it in mind that I never argue with Jean. Ever. Are there any announcements that I don't have this morning that should be made?
Yes.
Hey.
Today, we the youth would ask that any loose offerings would be given to the Stop Hunger Now initiative.
Very good, the loose offering. Very good.
So we just want to talk for a quick second about Stop Hunger Now and just how amazing it is. And I believe last year we brought it to our church, and a lot of people here were here and were involved in that. And it's, I don't know where it's happening this year again, but I know it's happening on June 26th. Of this year, and
there's a fundraiser on June 26th.
Yes.
So be there.
Be there for it on June 26th. It's awesome.
It's amazing to give back and to package all these meals for people who can't get that. So it's amazing.
Yeah.
Food and music too.
Yeah, food and music. So that's not going to get you there.
Yes, food and music.
So I think that's it.
June 26th.
Yeah. It's Paul, there's a window, I guess. Okay. Before we celebrate the Lord's Supper, happy anniversary, sweetheart.
Aww.
46. Thank you, my dear. Let us bring forth our gifts now to celebrate our Lord's Supper.
Before we do that, we have a presentation.
Oh, you do, that's right.
We would like to ask the graduating seniors to please come forward. That means to the front. We have Karen Colley.
Kendall.
You are a graduating senior.
There's so many Colleys.
And Gabe Kelly. And absent, but in our hearts, Sydney Benet.
Okay. Hi. First, we're going to start off with Dana.
Well, let's see. I have known both Gabe and Kendall for a really long time. When I went back to look at all the pictures, they were so little. they were so little and so adorable. And I have to say, I think your smile, Kendall, sort of lights up every picture that I found of you. And I think that's sort of what I remember from the time when you guys first came to the church. You were just so energetic and full of joy and life and always sort of the smiling face of your very amazing, happy family. Definitely a blessing to all of us. And Gabe, you're always the serious one. Always so much more mature than your age actually is, which is also a blessing. You have blessed all of us with being a pastor-like figure inside the youth, blessing us with your reading and your ever-capable hands to help the pastor do the services for Youth Sunday many, many, many times over. Mostly always being Gabriel, being the angel Gabriel in our Sunday pageants, our Sunday school pageants, so Christmas pageants. So thank you so much for sort of the love that you've brought, the joy, and the giving of your time and of your spirit. Both of you have given a lot to the church, whether it's through your Boy Scouts or whether just being present and just really giving up all of your energy and time and love to all of us here. I think, I don't want to speak for all of us, but I just want to say thank you for sharing yourselves with us for this time, and we're so happy for you guys. And for Sydney, who's not here, she's also off to, going to be doing great things. She's graduating with a degree in environmental studies, and She's, she's blessed us so much with her music. She's grown so much since she came to St. Luke, and I'm so proud to know her, and I'm hopefully going to try and hook her up with some people in the environmental world to see if we can get her a job. even outside of her amazing science knowledge, she's just blessed all of us with her music continually, and she improves every time we see her. She does even more amazing things. So I think our church family is really blessed to have all of them, and sad if they leave us.
Thank you.
I don't know. I just wanted to add something Dana said too about the Gabe seriousness. If you're ever here on our Friday nights when we practice this thing, we like Gabe's seriousness because Gabe keeps us in line, he keeps us focused, and so we're going to miss that leadership that he brings to us. And Kendall, same thing Dana said. We love her enthusiasm, her love of life. So we'll miss that energy that she brings every Sunday to us.
All right. Gosh, it's pretty much all been said, except Kendall, I will miss your smile, like Dana said, and your good spirit, and your loving heart, and just everything about you, but I know you'll be back.
Of course.
Yes. And Gabe? Gabe is the serious one, but he also is so full of ideas. Ways to do things, and he's a shining light, and he has been with leadership for what, this is the fourth or third time you've been the assistant pastor for Youth Sunday?
Too many to count.
I will certainly miss you, but you're not going far away, so you could possibly be here on Sunday.
Forever!
And Sydney, what else can you say about the music? I wish I had gotten to know her better, but the little bit I did, I wish her all the happiness and look forward to seeing her here whenever she can come. And we have a little something for all of you. Dana, if you'll get it, it's by passing.
Gabe is also soon to become an Eagle Scout.
I am actually an Eagle Scout.
Oh, he's an Eagle Scout. Go to church because your mama says to. Visit grandpa every chance that you can. Hold the door, say please, say thank you. Don't steal, don't cheat, and don't lie. I know you've got mountains to climb, but always stay humble and kind. When the dreams you're dreaming come to you, when the work you put in is realized, let yourself feel the pride, but always stay humble and kind. Don't expect a free ride from no one. Don't hold a grudge or a chip, and here's why. Bitterness keeps you from flying. Always stay humble and kind. When it's hot, eat a root beer popsicle. Shut off the AC and roll the windows down. Let that summer sun shine. Don't take for granted the love this life gives you. When you get where you're going, don't forget to turn around and help the next one in line. Always stay humble and kind. I love you guys. Okay, hug time. see the thing. Okay, help. Okay, thanks.
Let's now bring forward our gifts to celebrate the Lord's Supper.
That's all they're bringing.
as you have raised us to new life in Christ. Give us glad and generous hearts, ready to praise you and to respond to those in need. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and our duty, our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty, merciful God, for the glorious resurrection of our Savior Jesus Christ, the true Paschal Lamb who gave himself to take away our sin, who in dying has destroyed death, and in rising has brought us to eternal life. And so with Mary Magdalene and Peter and all the witnesses of the resurrection, with the earth and sea and all creatures, angels, archangels, we praise your name and we join their unending hymn. For his coming into the world to fulfill for us your holy will and to accomplish all things for our salvation. And in the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body. It is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup and he gave thanks. He gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, and it is shed for you, for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this always in remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Remembering, therefore, his salutary command, his life-giving passion, his death, his glorious resurrection and his ascension, and the promise of his coming again, we give thanks to you, O Lord God Almighty, not as we ought, but as we are able. We ask you mercifully to accept our praise and our thanksgiving, and with your word and Holy Spirit to bless us, we your servants, and these your own gifts of bread and wine, so that we and all who share in the body and blood of Christ may be filled with every heavenly blessing and receive the forgiveness of sin and be formed to live as your holy people and be given our inheritance with all of your sins in light. For to you, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be all honor, all glory in your church, both now and forever.
Amen.
Now, Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
For this one bread, this one chalice, it makes us one family, one people, though we are many.
Thank you.